Switzerland, people come together in the evening to discuss around the table things which are on their mind, which are of concern to them. That's exactly what we want to do with this Swiss Touch table. We want to have discussions on topics looking to the future with American and Swiss experts. And for this table will travel throughout the United States, wherever the action happens, like here in Ashokan Reservoir.
Welcome to our conversation around the Swiss Touch table. Today we will be talking about sustainable water management.
New York City is one of five large cities in the United States that have water so pure at its source. It still delivers very high quality water to the people, to the 8.5 million people who live in New York City, without doing filtration of its Catskill Delaware supply.
And what's happened is over time is that there's been a growing awareness that it's not only the things you can see, like turbidity, which is really obvious, but things that maybe are invisible. Things like pharmaceuticals, which are coming actually from the wastewater. And since we're all downstream from somebody, unless maybe you live in Switzerland.
Safe drinking water at all times. Consumers change their behavior when something tangibly impacts them. Sandy was another storm I'd rather forget. This storm could be related to climate change, and we have to prepare for the future.
But there is still a very strong degree of confidence on the part of the public in both New York City and also in Switzerland.
Innovative, multi-faceted project. Passive systems, like we're looking at a nice picture of a wetland here, and these can be quite effective, actually, lowering the levels of pathogens.
We wouldn't know that except for the research. Also in Switzerland, which is often seen as the water castle of Europe, there's an institution here at ETH, there's a partner institution, EAVAC, that's also very active with research on water. Paul, you actually spent some time at EAVAC.
I did, and I really learned a lot in my time at ETH and EAVAC that I was able to apply when I came over to work for New York City in a watershed resource protection mode. That's right, the world's largest ultraviolet disinfection facility went into operation in 2012 in just north of New York City in Westchester County, and all the water that comes from the Catskills now is treated with UV light to provide an extra level of protection.
I think that one of the things that has impressed me about the Swiss is they have a very long-term vision, being willing to invest in these sort of long-term security and safety. By and large, when it's out of sight, it's out of mind, I feel like, in the American consciousness. We do have to make these investments, not only in research, but infrastructure, if we're going to secure a future.
Chris McNeill, Paul Roche, thank you so much for your contribution today.